go, where I will be. Now catch me right on the road to Spain. Well, folks, that was weird. Got the potential camping spot, and I just got out and heard that bird gobble like 150, 200 yards away. Responded right away, and I'm like, here we go. It's 12 o'clock in the afternoon. This bird's gonna come in. I ended up chasing him for like a mile. He kept gobbling for a while, but I couldn't really get ahead of him. And right when I thought maybe I'd get ahead of him, I just didn't hear from him for a while. So more importantly, we'll hopefully roost some birds tonight, but definitely birds in the area, so it's cool. Just couldn't get on them. I don't even think my favorite part of this hunt is the birds, man. This area is so cool to go on a bunch of two tracks. Thank God we got four-wheel drive, but it's freaking gorgeous. I think we'll hear a couple birds tonight. Trying to get ears on a few birds and enjoy the freaking view. It's incredible. Love it out here. Well, guys, I just screwed up my double, but I got one bird. I couldn't get the camera going. They were way over there. I did a little bit of hen yelping, and they came right in. Those two toms. The second one, I threw two shots at when he was running, which I probably shouldn't have, and I don't think I hit him. I'm going to look and make sure he's not wounded, but I don't even have any more ammo on me. I only had three shells. But that right there is a dead Montana turkey. It's not the end of the world missing that bird, because we got a whole week. I couldn't get the camera set up in time. They came in insanely fast. Right off the freaking roost. Well, folks, a little upset I missed that double. I really hope I didn't wound that other bird, but to call in two toms right away in the morning. Not a big bird, but hey, those Merriams are absolutely incredible, man. Absolutely beautiful. Fun. Freaking real. Thank you, buddy. It's freaking beautiful. We'll go look. Make sure I don't see any feathers or anything from that other bird. Then we gotta hike back to the truck with a dead bird, baby. Blessed to be in a place like this, that is for sure. I mean, straight in. It was like two different calling sequences. Called the first time, they responded. I started slipping up on them, and they were like closed the distance already. And this country out here is incredible. I just dropped the bird off on the two track, and I'm gonna grab the truck so I can save a half, three quarter mile, whatever it is, of carrying a turkey. So I'm pretty sure I heard another bird hammer over here. This place. You know it's a quick kill when your coffee's still warm in the truck. Kill those birds a little after six, so
pretty early. Nothing I didn't mention. So I called, they responded, I slipped up, called, they were even closer. There's this field they had to cross, and at one point they one of them gobbled in the middle of the field, and obviously a lot closer. But when they were like 35, 40 yards in front of me, one of them just gobbled right in my face, and then they kind of started running to my right. Got pretty close, about a 20, 25 yard shot on the one bird, and then obviously whiffed on the other one. But that's okay. It's a learning experience. I should have called to really try to stop him. I just thought since he wasn't running very hard yet that I could kill him. But if anything from waterfowl hunting will tell me, I cannot hit moving things. So probably just shot behind him. So four extra bucks of lead just blown into the soil of the Powder River Breaks here in Montana, but that's okay.
Why the long face, this Sammy? Why'd you come dragging in here? Sit down, boy, before you hurt yourself, and I'll let you bend my ear. Love is a bitch, ain't it, buddy? When baby turns the tables on your head. No, you came in here to bring back her, leave her, I'll leave you with this instead. I know where the hole in the clinch, river, and I know how to find them bass. I know how to tune a six-string mountain, kick Saturday in the ass. I know how to make that moonshine, I know you want your sunshine back. I know a whole lot about a little something, something, and a whole bunch of nothing by day. A whole bunch of nothing by day.
Well, that's a cool start to the trip. There's a lot of elk. Look at them all back in the field too. And there's some muleys in there. Probably not used to seeing cars come down in here. Gorgeous animals, man. Just cool country out here. Well, folks, we have made it, but road conditions are... It's not going to be a road hunting trip. So, just fine. Got about an hour and a half till sunset. Hopefully we can hear some birds from camp, but we'll probably be on our feet pretty early tomorrow.
My mind took a vacation, had a situation like you got. They tell me that I had a good woman, all bad, but I can't remember what I forgot. I just kick back and listen up, son, I'll help you get to where I am. Yet you're going full throttle and leaning on a bottle as a bed and a coffee can.
but we're back at the cows, so you know we're back at camp. We're dealing with some smart birds. Got on a bird, hard gobbling for Merriam, so I think it's an older bird. I tried to get him to come down the bottom like they've been doing. He wouldn't. One hen pitched from a ridge over, went to him. He went quiet for like 10, 15 minutes. So I think he bred her. And then it sounded like he was working on the other side of this flat, this top. So I went to circle around. And as I was coming up on the edge, I got caught because he was on 75, 80 yards away just hammering. And of course, you know, I did a little bit of light calling and scratching. He wouldn't come. Did a Jake yelp. Started hammering. Wouldn't come. So I tried to do a huge circle around him. And I think he could hear me walking on this edge. And he started gobbling again and came over to this edge. And I don't know if he saw me, but I tried to creep up and shoot him and I didn't see him. So I don't know if he spooked or what's going on. But that's a smart bird. We might take a hen decoy in there later. But it's just so open, it's tough to get these birds to really come tight to you. Now there's a few more gobbling over in this direction. So I'm going to work up on this ridge after eat some breakfast here and see what happens. But first we'll take a little bit of break, catch up on water. Get some turkey apple breakfast sausage in us, a couple of eggs, and be good to go. And get away from these fucking cows, because they're a lot of shit. Bastards. Well, guys, I got out the call into the piece where I heard some birds yesterday, and across the way, there's three toms gobbling. They're working on this edge, and it's actually a little bit of private down here. So I'm going to have to drive down this two-track that hopefully Onyx isn't lying about. I can get over, slip up on a national forest, and try to slide down. It's going to be tight. It's going to be aggressive, but they're hammering, and I think once we're close to them, they'll come right in, but you never know. They are turkeys after all. So, let's get going. Well, guys, chaos happened again, and I wasn't able to get the camera on. I was in this piece where I knew there's gobblers down low, and they weren't really responding. I was like, I'll just work up in here. There ended up being two groups of birds, and each group had three birds in it. One was just down in there, and then right behind me they just started hammering. And so I was like, setup wise I'm a little confused what I should do. And so these birds to my right hammered super close, so I just show you my setup. Let me drop the turkey vest. And by the way, it's my first Jake, but I didn't even know if they're Jakes or Toms. I guess he had a weaker gobble, but most Merriams do anyway, so it's hard for me to tell. But so they hammered just down in here. I sat up on this tree, and I could just see them. There's this trail, and I could just see all three birds coming up it. And first bird, I stopped. You probably can see where he was shot, maybe. I don't know, somewhere in here. Shot the first bird, and yeah, it's my first Jake, and I'm fine with that. That was so cool, man. It's meat in the freezer, tagged out in Montana, although I'm gonna come back up here and hunt with a friend. He wants to hunt up here. I don't care if that other group was Tom's or not. That was freaking incredible. This area has a ton of birds. But anyways, he is not a bad Jake. I mean, small. Show you his beard. I think I smoked him pretty good. Yeah. There it is. My first ever Jake. Isn't that cute? Oh man, I don't care if they were Toms or not. That was, to have two groups of birds hammering. Tagged out in Montana. We just got a bird in South Dakota and a bird in Wyoming to kill. That was freaking cool. Powder River Breaks, special. See, I'll get a fan picture for you. Well, guys, we have our last Montana bird of 2021. And it's my first Jake. Him and his buddies were hammering. And aren't these Merriams just absolutely gorgeous? Time to hack them out, pack them out, and get home. Guys, before I end this video, I apologize for not killing them on camera, but turkey hunting comes first. I might have been able to set up a camera to watch that, but watching a Jake take two steps out and blast it is the most exciting thing in the world. This place is beautiful. I don't mean this lightly, but Powder River Breaks might be one of my favorite places on the earth. Maybe just because I get to hunt turkeys here, but public land, lots of it. So many birds, so many wildlife. You got antelope, you got elk, and awesome western style Merriam's hunt. This is it. I'll be back here, maybe have some footage from that. Even though I could have had two toms last week, I'm happy I shot that because this led to an amazing weekend of hunting. Gobbling almost non-stop, it felt like. And, I'm ready to get back home and shower because I am nasty, but I really earned it for this bird. I put on a lot of miles per day. I don't know, probably a minimum of 10. And it can be some steep country, but I don't mean that to complain. I mean that as it's been awesome to get out and explore. And thank you guys for watching. I'll have more turkey content, I hope, coming for you. Two more tags to fill. Let's get it done. Yeah.